I had spent 3 or 4 years on the Manhattan Project. I spent a year in 1942 working on the building the first reactor with Wigner and Fermi in Chicago. And this was a very inspiring activity with a real prospect for a tremendous new source of energy, which I think enthused everyone at the time, namely the development of a nuclear reactor, a fission reactor. Then early in 1943, I joined the Los Alamos project, which was aimed at kind of designing and building the first atomic bombs. And we were just starting up on the hill at the time. In fact, when I first joined the project, the housing was not available up on Los Alamos Mesa at that time. We were transported up there daily from down in the valley. But this was a very challenging problem with many, many different aspects. And our problem there was we not only wanted to see how to do it, but we wanted actually to solve all of the practical problems and prepare actual bombs for use as soon as possible. We had a very strong motivation during much of this time because our fear was that Germany would be developing atomic bombs and might well develop them before we were able to. This motivation, I think, is what pulled the whole project together and made it accomplish so much in such a short time. My particular role there involved designing parts of the Nagasaki bomb. And so I was familiar with what had been done with atomic bombs during that period of 1943 through 1945. Later on, I left the project in order to work on more normal physics interests, so that I was not directly involved in the hydrogen bomb project that was continued on and developed hydrogen bombs later on. Nevertheless, I had the general background that enabled me to be able to deal with these problems without having a great deal of introduction.